Godspeed! Chicken's place. Enter at your own risk. Skate for free. You inline skate more often than you skateboard?
Yeah, I do. And when I'm back home, it's 50-50. I don't really skateboard that much because I'm more of a ramp skater.
Right.
And there's not as many ramps in America as we have back home.
Is the inline skating as popular in Australia as it is in the States?
No, we've got a lot of inline skaters in Australia, especially a lot that focus on ramps and bowls.
Right.
In America, I think they're more concentrated on street skating.
Street skating in New York City is the bomb. There's nothing like it. I mean, I don't care what anybody says. You can skate from one point to the other. We don't have to hop in a cab or hop in a car or, you know, even hop on the train for that matter.
If you get bored, you can go to the west side. If you get bored from there, you can go to the east side. You can go uptown, downtown.
For every New York skater, street is where it's at.
This all started out, you know, a couple of donuts at the banks, a little coffee, you know, early morning skate session.
I think the Banks is pretty much a mecca for skating in New York City. The Banks is known worldwide. The Banks is famous everywhere. Anybody who skates skateboards or inline skates knows about the Banks.
You fall in love with it. You know, you have the wall to jump over, two perfect handrails that are there, you know, that are, you know, just saying, jump on me, learn to skate, you know, from here. You can grind. You can rail, you can air, you can do anything, you know what I mean? It's the perfect skate spot.
What we did was, on the trip, we went down to the Wall Street area. Skating there, there's a lot of stuff to hit. There's a lot of good, like, gaps, and there are a lot of good rails and stuff. It's not good to skate in the daytime, especially during the week.
People get pretty scared and come running up in front of you. You know, we never hit them and stuff, so it's all good. Like, you know, you come by, you know, they don't know to move. You know, you're about to hit each other and you move at the last minute.
People are always getting on your tail about, you know, skating here. You can't skate here. You can't do this. You can't do that.
We just do what we got to do and we just keep going because we can't stop. If we stop, we get jacked.
Will you get out or I call the police?
Which is New York City,
kids. It's chill, though. It's kind of cool. I mean, you kind of skate, hit a spot and break and you leave and then you're okay. Man, I've seen kids get like hit by cars. I mean, like bad. I've seen this kid totally rent, like going 30 miles an hour, smack into the back of a parked van.
Do you get to play-by-play for us? I can see I'm watching this being totally ignorant, so help me out, man. Educate me.
This kid right here is saying Brian Patch.
Did he rip some speed?
Yeah.
See ya.
Always consistent moves as well. Omar's just always solid and consistent on everything. I saw him on a guy. He was voted Skater of the Year last year by Crasher Magazine.
Right here?
He's mostly known for his innovative street skating, switch stance skating. Hey, what's that? That's a doubles line. This is Ricky Smiles. One of the best full skaters in the world. You see, he's just got crazy fire in his eyes.
One, two, three, four.
What do you think about, you know, street skating?
I think that you put back money into skateboarding by, you know, pay for insurance and stuff, so the park's closed. And now the kids skate the street.
Yeah.
You know, they like street skating because it's other people's property. My brother's got $13,000 in skateboarding tickets warrants.
It is a crime.
Like I said before, thank God for the country.
The scene in Nashville is real positive. All the kids that skate here are really good, and when people come through, I think that they're surprised, because lots of people think, you know, well, you're in Tennessee, you know, you guys don't wear shoes there.
The scene in Nashville usually looks down on skaters, just because we're a little bit different.
Skating in places like Nashville, it can get you in trouble because of how close-minded people around here are. It's wherever you're skating, you know, you just look like a troublemaker to them.
As far as skateboarding being a crime, it is as far as being prohibited.
Most part, cops are just jerks anyway.
After you've been advised and you continue to skate, then it gives us probable cause to take appropriate action.
They got a, you know, personal vendetta out against us, you know, before they even come out and bust us.
Well, they do challenge us, and when they do, we catch them, we'll arrest them.
You know, they got to do what they got to do, but, I mean, they could be a little bit cooler about it.
A decade that's shaping up to be even more embarrassing than the 70s. Want proof? This Saturday, beginning at 10 a.m., MTV's counting down the top 100 of the 90s, 4 years early. Relax, reminisce, and revisit those precious, fairly recent music video moments with special appearances by Elle McPherson, Snoop Doggy Dogg, Tupac Shakur, Daphne Zuniga, and more. MTV's Top 100 of the 90s, Saturday beginning at 10 a.m. We're not just counting backwards, we're making history.
Sort of.
Well, you know, we feel like if we're going to start getting kicked out of the city in Nashville, that we might as well just take it upon ourselves to build ramps and, you know, build the way we want it. We decided to go ahead and put some ramps up, you know, ourselves. So we went out to the junkyard.
Who should take the bike?
Yeah, do that.
We'll probably jump this here. We can make it a launch in it.
Picked up some stuff to do some tricks over, and it turned out to be a pretty fun day. You can find a lot of things, like just like a refrigerator uses a box to do grinds on and stuff, or just like trash cans to do tricks over and stuff. Just, you know, you can find a bunch of stuff that people are throwing away and use.
Check the flow, watch me stroll. See, I'm that fool that makes you lose control. Cause it goes like this.
No, it goes like this.
Yeah, it goes like this.
No, it goes like this.
My head goes like this.
It goes like this.
And there goes a little something like this.
The city puts up basketball courts, baseball fields, swimming pools, and that's all public. And, you know, they get to do that for free, so why can't I do what I do for free?
I think if we can do this in, like, one afternoon, the city can take a little bit of time, maybe a month. They can have something. It's not really hard. Just a little bit of nails and a hammer.
Are you okay?
Oh, yeah.
From Dallas?
Try and get a taste of the mic. I'm from Dallas, Texas.
Before I even get into, like, the inline skating or anything, you're a Cowboys fan? You call
I'm a Cowboys fan. Why? Are you going to show me your
shirt?
I don't want to see it.
Wait, why did you call it rollerblading?
Why do I call it rollerblading? Because that's what it is. That's what most people know it as. It's the easiest. Inline skating's too much, sounds too...
Is inline skating the politically correct?
It is.
Okay.
So I'm trying to make waves.
Where do you see yourself, say, 10, 15 years from now?
Wheelchair?
Honestly?
I don't...
You go that hard?
Well, it's brutal, and I'm realizing, like, I'm just 22 now, and I'm starting to feel injuries so much. It's like, I feel like I'm going from one injury to the next, you know? Just trying to find some time to skate in between.
Is it perceived any different in New Zealand than it is here in the States? Or
you know, a lot of people ask me because there's so many good skaters from New Zealand.
Right.
Scott Bentley, Tash Hodgson, Alan Barnett, all these great skaters that come out of such a small country. It's because it's more geared towards this type of skating, the ramp, the street. There's not so much recreational skating. It's seen more as just purely a sport. Litigation law here has messed up the kids' ability to have fun. There are no more parks because of insurance.
Right.
In New Zealand, the councils are encouraged to build these parks so the kids will stay off the street.
After the skate park.
Been skating in Encinitas since it's been open. Communities just want a place for these kids to go, stay out of trouble, so they built the skate parks.
It's a really good idea for up here in Encinitas, considering they banned skateboarding on the streets, so the kids have nowhere to go.
I like that that you can go somewhere without having to worry about getting in trouble. You know, you come down here with your friends, and every time you go out, someone does something to you, you go home, and you're just like, damn, that was dope.
This is pretty much the best skate park I can think of in the country that I've been to. They have great vert ramp, huge street course, and they just did the new mini ramp, which is really good too.
Come on!
The way they keep it up so nicely and they have a variety of terrain to ride, it's a really good example for other parks to follow. As far as the vert ramp goes, it's probably one of the more interesting vert ramps because it's got an elbow and a hip on it and some corners, which is not too usual. One thing about my skating is I eat a lot.
Yeah!
A lot.
Ouch!
What's your worst injury you ever had?
Well, I've broken my hand 8 times. Busted my ribs, smashed my head, twisted ankles.
You could actually break your neck.
Well, we had one guy hit his head,
yeah.
When the convulsions and everything. 911.
Oh, see, so it's not that dangerous at this point.
Oh, no. I was hitting this railing,
yeah.
And it was 15 stairs, and I came off it and just whacked my head so hard.
Stuyvesant rail is probably one of the craziest rails here in the city. It's like 22 steps down, it kinks and it curves, and it's like another 22 steps long, and it's really sick and it's fast as hell. And these dudes are like just nutty, man. They're jumping on it, and Rawlinson got jacked, basically, is what happened. He went down the first kink, hit the kink, kind of spun off the rail, and hit his shin on the thing, and didn't look that bad. Man, his shin opened up like that big. I mean, his shin was this big. You could see right to his shin bone. It was incredible.
No, Rawlinson, you're going to the hospital, dude.
The whole hospital thing really sucked.
Sister Margareta would like to learn how to rollerblade.
Are you one of the characters on those rollerblades?
Yeah.
Oh, God, help you.
somebody gets hurt like that, you know, it really makes you think, you know, maybe that could have been me.
Well, it's going to hurt a little bit, but not that much.
You know, you get hurt, and that's part of skating. So we took him to the hospital, left him there, and we went on skating because that's what we were doing.
Actually, we didn't meet. I've been sort of supervising your care. He's got a laceration that it's going to require about 10 stitches, I think.
Hi, I'm Jake, and if you find it hard being Snoop D-O-double-G, then you'll love Squirt TV.
I need TP for my bunghole. Are you threatening me?
Hi, I'm Rob Schneider.
God, I would love to.
This is Squirt TV.
Squirt TV on MTV. American Justice in Action. Tonight at midnight.
Hi, I'm Tabitha Soren with an MTV News Brief. Last Tuesday, U.S. Customs officials banned the importation of Rohypnol, a sedative 10 times as strong as Valium, after the drug was associated with a rising number of date rapes. Officials in Florida are investigating several cases where women were unknowingly given Rohypnol and then sexually assaulted. You may recall that Kurt Cobain overdosed on Rohypnol and alcohol in Rome 1 month before his suicide. That's the news for now. More on this and other stories throughout the day here on MTV.
A lot of skate parks are made for skateboarders. So it's kind of like, you know, a little bit lame for us because of the stuff we do with like big handrails and doing all kinds of other stuff. But the parks are slowly catching on. Like Encinitas has that fun box and they're putting up more piping for grinding and stuff like that.
I can't get roots down, I put my roots down. I can't get roots down, I put my roots down. That's how we gonna kick it roots down.
Yeah, how you wanna kick it?
Gonna kick it roots down.
As the inline skaters go, I don't have a problem with them. I get along with them just fine. I do see them getting frustrated with the skateboarders.
I really, really get pissed off when people want to rag me because I'm an aggressive inline skater. It's like, you know, I could care less. You know, I'm not doing my thing. You do your thing and leave me alone, you know? And I totally respect skateboarding. I love skateboarding. I just like skating better.
It's not a good place for a rollerblader to be in the middle of a snake session. You know, we're putting out our boards and we're just charging in. All they have to put out is their little foot. They can't really hear when they're gonna go. It's just pure ignorance or just stubbornness. They don't want to accept the fact that we're trying to make our own sport. I'm not trying to copy their sport, although their sport has influenced our sport a lot. A lot of inline skaters look up to skateboarders because they realize that it's a rad sport too as well. It'd be cool if skateboarders could look at us the same way, I suppose.
Pretty average day for me. A lot of falling. A lot of smashing the body.
Now I'm just gonna go home and relax.
So you're pretty much the man.
I don't know about that.
All I've got is a skateboard. And a guitar.
All the guys that are pro are doing it because they love it. They're not doing it because they feel like it's their job.
In the day and age of professional athletics where you see guys making you know, $5 million a year, $10 million a year, you're not going to find that kind of money-winning a skateboarding competition. Right. So I would imagine the majority of the guys you see out here are still doing it just because
of the
sport.
And it was, I mean, it was in a lull for the last couple of years. So
what do you think brought it back?
I think there's just a renewed excitement because it's been progressing.
Has the street at all helped bring it back?
I think right when it was sort of dying last time, that's when the street was coming in.
Right.
And then suddenly, when it was back in the public eye, people said, wow, you know, these kids are going down handrails, they're going big stairs, it's, you know, they're pulling big stunts, basically.
No matter where you go in the park, you're bound to step on something else that you can skate. It's perfect for, you know, inline skating.
Yo, what's going on, man?
No, Robinson, you're going to the hospital, dude.
Took 5 hours to stitch me up.
Can you get me a number 11 scalpel
blade? Okay. What time is it now?
7:30?
We got in here, what, 2 o'clock?
Let's go.
It's New York City. Traffic's crazy. Everybody's crazy. It's a crazy city. And I think to skate here, you just gotta be a little crazy yourself.
Doing what you do professionally, how long can you do this for and still compete, like, at a strong competitive level?
Well, like, for myself, Christian, Lance, you know, some of these guys are all my heroes, you know? And they're still skating, competing, doing well in contests.
He's, like, 34 years old, and
he's
doing better than he ever has.
And now what we've got to be careful of is losing focus of what our sport really is. Because things like this, like skateboarding and rollerblading, focus shouldn't really be on competition. I mean, it's about self-expression.
These guys are cool riders. They skate strictly on sole purpose.
Exactly.
You know, and that's real.